Good morning, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Thank you for joining me. Today is Wednesday, December 14th, 2022. We got a look at the upper Geyser Basin from the Old Faithful webcam. Once in a while, the steam I've noticed this morning has been going dark. Then it goes clear. There was recently a magnitude 3.8 earthquake that USGS is not reporting. Four different monitors that I downloaded. It could have come from the Sawtooth area. Here we have Maple Creek. We got Soda Butte next to that western boundary. And Little West Thumb. Let's see. We'll go to the spectrogram for Maple Creek. And we'll go to the seismic signature for western boundary. It does not show up at Little West Thumb, so that's why I say it's probably the Sawtooth where this earthquake came from. Let me go there, and we'll go there. I don't know if you can see this little line that moves across to the area of that earthquake right there. See that? You can see it's snowing pretty hard. Currently, the temperature is 15 degrees. And winds, yeah, I think it's greater than 2 miles an hour. It was up to 40 earlier. And we're looking at Lion, I believe this is. The boreholes are not working. Here we got borehole 206. Bring it over, yeah. We'll go to another borehole, 208 for Yellowstone Lake. Yep, has been working for 3 days. 944 for Grant. Yep, not working. Let's see here. 945 in general for the park. Yeah, absolutely nothing. Surprise, surprise. Norris Geyser Basin. Yeah, again. Yeah, nothing since the second. Look at that. Yeah, I tried to get borehole 207 to download. Yeah, no such luck. We can send people to the moon, and they want to send people to the moon again. But we can't keep the monitors up and running, which Congress requested that they do 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. Yeah, heaven help us if there's an eruption. And yeah, you'll find out more than likely through social media. Many of you will hear it before you get anything on social media. Here we have Soda Butte. I wanted to see if it was still screaming. This was yesterday at 12:45 p.m. I believe 11:45 there at the park, and this was yesterday, and there's its seismic signature where it came in. And then there was another one, let's see, right there, 1:45 p.m. or 12:45 p.m. there at the park. Yeah, that's interesting that both of those are at almost per minute, but within an hour. Yeah, that's interesting. Some popping's been going on. Yeah, there's one there. Another one there. Let's bring it down. What do we got when I pulled the files? Not too much going on today. Is that the right spot? Nope, right there. 231 Universal. That would have been 7:31 p.m. Oh, they do have one marked in red. Let's see if I can find it. Right there. 1:51 Universal. 6:51 p.m. That would have been yesterday. Let's look at the spectrogram. Yeah, not too much at Soda Butte today. All right, Maple Creek. Yeah, quite a few marked in red. Once again, they don't have anything listed on USGS. We got that one right there. There's the seismic signature. That one there is the last earthquake that USGS, I believe, reported. That would have been yesterday, 10:35 p.m. local time. Yeah, I have to laugh. USGS says it was a magnitude 0.4. Another way they're very deceiving, it says here, Idaho, Montana, border region. Yeah, it's by Hedgen Lake. 8.5 miles below sea level. I don't know how they can continue to get away with their lying. It was actually one quick little jolt, and then there was another one afterwards. Let me make that bigger. Okay, we'll go back to that. See that? It actually comes in as a magnitude 2.25. Can you believe that they would post it as a 0.4? Even if, you know, you can kind of see how it trails off here. Even if I take off the full extent of the seismic wave, it would come in as a magnitude 1.84. And then we got another one over here. This one is not being reported. Let's see, 5:57 Universal, 10:57 p.m. local time. Let's look at the seismic signature. I'll have to make that bigger again. Yeah, I don't know why the program shrinks down on me. Let me check this out. Okay, so that comes in as magnitude 1.60. Now, they only reported one earthquake, which is listed for today, but it's actually was late last night. One for yesterday, a 0.6. Well, we got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9, 10 for the 12th. All within the Madison River area. It looks like the largest being a magnitude 2.1. Remember, when they start having magnitude 2s, they're supposed to be getting concerned, but yet they got the boreholes all shut down. Yeah, here we got the Madison River area. And over here is Hedgen Lake. Over here on the right is the time. You can see right here, this is when it changes over to today, the 14th. You can see there's a lot more than one earthquake, and I only downloaded it for a short period of time, even today. Yeah, you can see all the earthquakes. I was looking for screaming that possibly could have been happening here at Maple Creek, but I don't really see anything like that going on. Little West Thumb looks unusually quiet, but they got the microvolts for recording the earthquakes cranked up so low you can't really see anything that was going on. Here at the bottom you can see for a Little West Thumb, I got the magnification cranked up to 955. Same with Soda Butte, 952. Western Boundary, I only had to put it at 552. And then Maple Creek, that was at 552. You can see this other earthquake here that came in on both monitors just a little while ago. Yeah, I don't have that one. I did not download that data. So that would be the Madison River area. Yeah, and again, they're not reporting it. If it was not concerning, then why are they censoring the data? Why are they censoring the information if there was nothing, absolutely nothing to worry about? Here we have the western boundary, which is down below Hedgen Lake. That's the western entrance. You can see we got lots of popping that was going on earlier. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, tectonic in nature, it looks like. Yeah, the faults were moving. Let's see what it was showing when I pulled the files. Let me make that bigger. Okay, we'll go to the spectrogram. Let's enlarge that. Yeah, volcanic tremors. Okay. Let me go back here. Go back there. Harmonic tremors. Yeah, the lines of melt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Remember, supposedly there's a river of lava underneath Yellowstone, and they're now saying that the melt is anywhere from 15% to 20%. But we don't have to worry until it gets to 30% melt. Right? Yeah. Yeah, nothing to see. Move along. Yeah, we got some more there. Let me pull this up. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, we got popping. That one's marked in red. Well, why they got the camera down here at Firehole River? This is one of the springs, whatever, down there in the river. Yeah, it's looking dirty. Remember, it's got to be like 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit for the water, the heated water, to actually melt the rock to bring up the particles that we see when the steam for these geysers goes dark. See how it goes light, and then it goes dark and light as more water comes into the system. Yeah, all I can do is shake my head. So what are your thoughts? Please put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your support. You know who you are. Yeah, I've been getting some little Christmas bonuses from you guys there on PayPal and my Patreon account. Thank you. If you want to follow me, I'm also on Twitter. I often put earthquakes first that I see and other information on Twitter, because it takes me a while to do the editing for the videos. So, yeah, be prepared. You never know what type of disaster you'll have. Here currently we're waiting for snow to come in. It's been freezing rain for 2 days. No school for the kids for the last 2 days. They love that. Haven't lost power, but we're supposed to get heavy snow and winds later today. But I'm not worried because I am prepared. I have backup power sources and things like that. And I also have small things to use, burners, hot plates to cook my meals, and my power generator will run my microwave, refrigerator, freezers. And I can cook and have coffee. Yeah, I can even run my TV and my DVD player if the power goes out. So anyways, yeah, baby steps, do a little bit at a time to prepare for disasters. And if you're prepared, then you have less worry. So once again, thank you for watching. Thank you for your support. And I'll talk to you later. Now that's Beehive. God bless y'all. Bye. See, Beehive is a little dirty. It was dirtier earlier. Anyways, I'll give you a link to the live webcam so you can watch this. Yeah, this is actually took probably thousands of years to build up the deposits of the minerals to make this cone. And you can see how big it is by the size of the boardwalk. Anyways, I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.